Good evening, this is the Oscar Expert here with Brother Bro, and it's time to review The Menu. It's directed by Mark Millad, and it follows an evening where rich people go to this private island where they are served, like, the most exquisite, finely prepared food from a renowned chef played by Ralph Fiennes. But there may be other things in store for this journey, for it is not just about people eating food. It is kind of a dark comedy thriller. The film also stars Anya Taylor-Joy, Nicholas Hoult, and Hong Chow, all in roles that were really exciting and fun for them to be in. This film started off as an absolute banger. The first act of this movie is all just like pent-up anticipation for something we know is like lurking beneath the surface, but we're not sure what it is. And it comes out in explosive ways in the second act that are just pure joy and fun. I had a blast at this movie, as I know the audience did as well. It's also really funny, and I definitely laughed out loud at moments. And overall, it's just like, you can't really see where it's going to go. Perhaps this anticipation that's building, you know, throughout even the second act, does make it feel like it's gonna be such a high wire act to pull it all together. It's almost like they're promising too much. Like, how could this ever come together in such a satisfying way? Like, how could there be this grand master plan behind this that's going to satisfy everybody or make it feel like the payoff works 100%? I'm not sure if the film completely gets there, but honestly, it gets damn close for me. Yeah, I kind of thought that it would pull the rug out from under me at some point towards the last third. And for sure, there are a lot of unexpected twists and turns along this journey, and it was unpredictable, and I didn't know where it was going. But I do think in the end, the themes that it was ultimately exploring did feel like I kind of saw them coming. I was quite surprised because I actually found the themes resonated on a very deep level for me. And I ended up seeing myself in these characters, both in Ralph Fiennes' villain and his motivation, where he's coming from and why he wants to do what he's doing. And also seeing myself in the most kind of ugly ways in which these uber wealthy guests are excoriated throughout the film. And that was very surprising to me, that it kind of held up this mirror. Even for a film that wasn't taking itself too seriously, you know, it is pretty silly throughout. I was surprised the most. I'm surprised that it resonated like that with you too. I don't really mind this choice because I think it works for the style of the movie, but the characters are very movie-ish. Like, it is not going for realism. The characters are witty when the script requires them to be. If they need to, like, know that a plan is going to work and the script wants it to, like, it will. It makes the movie satisfying to watch because the script is very clever and sharp. But I didn't see that much in these characters that I thought resembled myself. Although, I understand what you were saying about it.
I was explaining to you what I took away from the film and you were getting it. It made a lot of sense. And the film is absolutely, like, putting that in there, and it wants people to discover that, because there is a weirdly poignant message in this film.
Yeah, but I think it's also very easy to not see yourself in the character because they are, like, you know, rich and, you know, pretentious, and they're not very down to earth. But overall, the movie is just very fun, and the writing is great. The dialogue is extremely witty. There's great dark comedy in here. The language that people use to, like, describe food is very funny. It's definitely satirizing that. The movie's also really well made. I thought that the crisp digital cinematography really fit this meticulousness of the characters and their, like, refined tastes. And a lot of it takes place in this, like, one large dining room. And the director does a great job finding ways to show when this room is, like, thrown off balance. The editing was very good as well.
The camera work is very fluid and seamless, and for a film where there's so many characters in a room, to have all these angles flow together seamlessly is actually a high wire act to plan all of the coverage out. That takes a lot to pull off, and this film does it seamlessly. It's just constantly hitting all the right notes. We really feel like we're going through the madness and mayhem that these characters are experiencing. I also really appreciated the production design and cinematography here. And the score. The score was surprisingly great. This is done by Colin Stetson, which was a surprise to me. Colin Stetson's music, it can feel very much like his. And that's nice sometimes. We're both really big fans of his. But in film scores, you almost want the music to feel like it belongs to the film rather than to the artist who's creating it. I wouldn't have guessed that it was him. He's using instruments that he doesn't normally use. He's using a lot of strings.
He leveled up His versatility went up. Yep. His skills as a film composer went up.
You know, I like to be nitpicky about scores. I really do. It's a theme lately. There's a piece that's used in the third act that feels a lot like the piece used in the end of Hereditary, which is a very famous piece that a lot of people love to use, and it's a great piece of music,
also by Colin Stetson.
Originally, I thought it was the composer that was trying to imitate the end of Hereditary, like they used it as a temp track and then they replaced it and they were like, yeah, this sounds enough like it, you know, we like what this is going for. And it feels like that was the direction, you know, we want this to sound like the end of Hereditary. And it did too much. I don't know if it being from Colin Stetson made that better or worse for me.
But so much of the music was different. All around, like the technical elements were a big highlight and the performances are great. Ralph Fiennes, he kind of does like his usual Ralph Fiennes villain type of thing, but I think there's depth in there. I think he brings something different to it.
Compulsively watchable, you might say. You're fearful of this guy, but he also has this great vulnerability. So he's just perfect in it.
Hong Chao is hilarious in this. I was like eating up everything that she did.
Yep.
What a good character actor, apparently. Really also enjoyed Nicholas Holt.
Yeah, he was really funny in it. And Anya Taylor-Joy was predictably great in this as well. I kind of wish they imbued her performance a little more with her background and where she was from. She's like a little bit hard to see as being where she's from in this, given that she's from Tennessee.
I did like Anya Taylor-Joy in this, but I wouldn't say it was like one of her best performances. The character, I would maybe say, was a little underwritten. I think she was kind of broadly defined by a couple key traits of her background, or maybe like one key trait. And then other than that, she was just like clever when the movie needed her to be clever.
Yeah, I think the more interesting character is Ralph Fiennes. You could almost see him as like the protagonist in the film. Which just makes him a great villain, like, you know, for a villain to feel like they could be in their own movie. His character and his arc is the most compelling of the film. It's where the actual poignancy and substance lies. And I really did find the commentary on pretentiousness and the way that wealth can kind of rot you from the core to be very powerful.
There were also some things that the more I thought about them felt a little inconsistent, and I wanted them to dive a little bit deeper into some of the guests where they seem to be kind of doing that in the second, like towards the middle of the movie.
I do expect that everybody will have a really great time at this movie, though. This is a hard one not to like, at the very least. I'm gonna give it a 9 out of 10 because it actually had an impact on me.
I'm kind of between a 7 or an 8 on this one. Thank you for watching. Thank you for subscribing.
If you created a menu, would you put mac and cheese on it?